G'day guys, it's Trav here from Neighbourhood. Are you wanting to offer unmissable deals, encourage conversions or downloads, or perhaps just inform customers before they leave your site? Well, this is where creating pop-ups on your homepage could help you out. We'll explore just how to implement them right now. As a heads up, this applies to all hubs that you use to use this feature. And if you're keen on more practical support inside HubSpot, Neighbourhood does offer a comprehensive, easy to follow course so you're making the most out of HubSpot. Stay tuned for more info at the end of this video. And if you want to take your learning offline, we'll include a downloadable PDF in the description below. So what we want to do here is create a pop-up on our website. So first things first, you want to just make sure that your tracking code is installed on your website. So this is a bit of an easy one. Most people do it as the very, 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 very first step when you get your HubSpot account. Now, if you're brand new to HubSpot, welcome. This is how you do it. I'll step you through it very quickly. So we go up to the cog. We want to go down to tracking and analytics, and we want to go to tracking code. So this tracking code here will allow us to do all of the great work that we have with our pop-ups and a whole bunch more, like tracking traffic and a whole bunch more. So what we want to try and do is we want to copy this. Now, if you are using WordPress, you're able to click on this one down here and you're able to just follow those instructions. If you're on HubSpot CMS, you've already got it installed, so you don't need to do anything. Well, welcome. But what we want to do is we want to install these into the header of every single page of the website. This will give us the ability to do the pop-up. So if you don't know how to do that, get in touch with us below in the comments. We'll be happy to help out in any way we can. Otherwise, there is plenty of documentation, both on YouTube and online, on how to do that through. So let's just assume you have this tracking code all installed. We want to go up to marketing and go down to lead capture and go to forms. Who would have thought the pop-up would live in forms, but it makes sense because we're trying to capture leads. At first, I was a little bit confused on exactly where to do the pop-up forms and where they were, but it's easy just to click on the orange button at the top right-hand side and it will give you these options. Now you'll see embedded form, standalone, pop-up box, drop-down banner, side left box, and side right box. The one we're looking at today is the pop-up box that we see here, but we are able to have little drop-down banners and little pop-ups on the left-hand side, and they do follow the same process as I'm doing now, so this is just a little bit different. So in this instance, we're gonna do pop-up box, but feel free to have a bit of a play around to sort of see what works for you. And make sure you're not too obtrusive with your pop-ups. Remember, don't be annoying. Don't be that guy. So we're gonna click on pop-up box and click on next. Now, that's gonna take us through to this, which is a fairly new updated sort of tool that we've got here. So first things first, always use a naming convention for your forms. So we're gonna say November pop-up promo form. So this is our pop-up that we've got here. So in this instance, we wanna do a promotion. Let's just say, for example, we have a website and we want you to go ahead and give us your email address and we'll give you 10% off your next purchase that you do. Awesome. So what we can do is we can have it nice and simple. So we can go sign up to receive 10% off your next purchase. Might just get my spelling right here. Enter your details. Now you might have a theme color or a color scheme on your website. Just make sure that you go through. You can enter the code there or you can select. These are our ones down the bottom here. So we might sort of say green. In this instance, you can see the change of the color. Now, if you want to add an image as well, depending on what the promo offer is or depends on what you're trying to say, you can upload an image or you can go through and select any images that you've got. So to say, for example, we want to add this image here, which is our summer of selling. We can put any image there. Less is more. Add it there if it adds value, but don't add something there if it doesn't add value, like this one. Cool, so we're gonna go through. Now we've got some options that we've got down here. Do we want it to be a step form? By step form, they mean they're gonna answer a question, click the button, move to a new form, and then enter some more information. Now we can go through and do that. In this instance, that's what we do wanna do, but we can actually direct them to other places. So a non-HubSpot URL, so it can go to a different domain altogether. HubSpot page or a blog post, a file download, a meeting link, or a calendar event. So in this, we want to do a step form because we want to capture that person's information. At the very top here, you'll see the next tab. So we're going to click on that and go through. Thanks for signing up. We're going to send you an email with the coupon code for to get the 10% off. Now, at the very, very high level, you might want to go through and just maybe ask for their first name, because you might have some personalization stuff in there that you might be like, hey, Trav, thanks for signing up. So that's there. And I'll also probably move that to the very top there. To do that, you just grab that little those little dots on the left-hand side. So you can see this is what it looks like on the right-hand side. Now, the form button text, you go through and then go to... send me my, give me 10% off. Now GDPR, if that's necessary in your region, do it. But in our region, it's not that necessary. And then we want to go English. We can go through and we can set a lifecycle stage automatically. In this instance, probably an MQL, depending on what the business is. So what happens is we enter those informations, they click on give me my 10%, and this is going to be the thank you. So we say, thanks a bunch, please check your email. There you go. Now, I'm not going to show you in this one, but you can go through and use the workflow tool or a little bit, the new automation tool a little bit after. So go ahead and actually create that email to send it through. You might want to add a button as well to sit there and go through going, check out our Facebook page. And you could just be here, www.facebook.com/BHCOAUS, I think it is. And then that would be a non, so when they click through that, they can actually go through and get that one too. Okay, this tab here, the automation tool, you're actually able to sit there and click and create a workflow or a simple workflow that can actually get a coupon code out to them. You can step through this how-to guide in order to do it. And you want to target, this is a really good one, you want to make sure that you only target specifically for this, the one page. So if they land on NBH Co, that's when it would show. We're actually able to also filter out specific behavior or information. For example, we can filter a device type, countries, if they've gone through our site a couple of times, if a form's been viewed since day's last visit, we can actually not show them this as well. Down the very bottom here, you can show it on exit intent, or you can do a lapse after a certain amount of time. Try not to get too annoying when people first rock up to it. So I would probably say a good 15 seconds after, but you can do 50% on scroll and also on the exit intent as well. You can schedule it for now or later. You can turn off for small devices like mobiles. And if it's been X'd out, it will not come back if they come back to the store. It will do it in 2 weeks' time. Pick what it is. A month is good for me. You don't want to annoy people too much. And then also, you want to make sure that they're notified. Now, in this instance, I don't want to be notified of every single person that gets the 10%, but if it's something important for your website, you can be notified. Say, for example, book a demo or something like that. And then we can preview it. So in here, we can click it. We can enter in our details, tw@ebh.co. And submit it, and then it will say thanks a bunch, please check your email. When you've done that, you can publish. Now, because we've gone through and we've actually gone and set up our tracking code on our website, now if we remember, we actually set the targeting, so it will show up on that location automatically. You don't need to do anything because the tracking code is on your site. So just remember, the targeting is going to be putting it on our main domain, but you might want to only put on a specific one. So this is the point that a lot of people get tripped up on, is, well, how do I install that now onto a site? All you need is a tracking code on the site, in the back end, in the header. Then when you set the targeting for that, it'll automatically show up on that page. And realistically, that's how you do it. So there you have it. Now you know how to create a pop-up inside HubSpot and make it show up on your website. Now, if you're wanting to make the most out of your HubSpot investment, Neighbourhood does offer a step-by-step course covering marketing, sales, service, and CMS Hub in depth, ensuring you and your team are serving your customers while developing efficient internal processes. We'll include a link for this below. As well, if you're after a PDF version of this for later, or you're passing it on to a mate in need, we'll include a link in the description as well. Now, if you've gained value from this video or you're keen to learn more about HubSpot, make sure you hit that subscribe button. But for now, that's it from me, and happy HubSpotting.